Hello guys, and welcome back again to my YouTube channel, Electon TV. And our troubleshooting video today guys is about ship's bow thruster. And now our ship guys is in the dry dock. Now guys, I'm here in the bridge, and as you can see, the motor overload lamp signal is activated. I cannot reset, and the bow thruster guys is not working, or they cannot use. And it was happened after the shipyard was overhauled the bow thruster motor. Now guys, here is the manual for the bow thruster, and I just want to explain first here how the overload alarm activate. Bow thruster service manual. And here guys, the signal lamp and also the push button for starboard and port side control of the bow thruster motor. And here is the overload signal lamp, and the other one is a reset button or buzzer or for the alarm reset button. Okay. And now guys, here is the drawing for alarm monitoring of the bow thruster. Here is the electronic board, bridge panel, bow thruster. And here is the electronic boards for alarm monitoring. Lamp test here, the button S3. S2 is the reset alarm buzzer. All deficiency gear. H3 is the signal lamp. And this one is the overload temperature. That's the thing that we need to check. Here also, disconnection motor temperature overload. alarm buzzer, lighting, ammeter, current meter, and this one signal for ready operation, H1. Okay, now we need to check for temperature and motor overload here. Okay, if we follow the line, we have K7, F11. We need to check for these two relay, because that's the relay that gives signal for overload. And this H2 is overload lamp signal. And here is K3, another relay that we need to check also. Based here in another drawing that I found for how the alarm work, we have here overload for 140%, motor overtemp, alarm suppression, control voltage available, warning for motor temperature, switching off, motor over temperature. We need to check this. Okay, let's start here for the overload. We have F13 here. If we follow the line going here in this reset, we need to close this contact, F13 relay, and we need to check for the page 1 column 4. Here is the page 5, therefore we need to check for the page 1 column 4. Okay, this is the page 1, guys, column 4. Here is the F13. F13, guys, is a current monitoring relay based here. And they are two. And this is the current transformer. Give signal to the current monitoring relay. And if the motor was overload, this current monitoring relay is activate. Also, this F11 is a current monitoring relay. And here is the current transformer. And this is the motor, guys. We have two current monitoring relay and two current transformer. Now, guys, this is the temperature monitoring relay, K8. We have two. We have a T1 and T2 terminal. It's the same in this K7, guys. Both is the same monitoring relay for temperature. And this is the thermistor that gives signal to the monitoring relay. And for example, this K8 was activated because of high temperature of the motor, or K7. This K8, just because here is close, and this K5 timer relay already have power, therefore this contact will be close. And K4 was energized. And if F13 current monitoring relay was closed, also this K3 contactor energized, this contact also will be closed. And this contact will be closed and give signal to the electronic monitoring control board. and they activate the overload signal lamp H2 and H7 also. Temperature overload, it's the same. And if another temperature control relay is activated, this is a K7. And this contact here from open will be closed and give signal here, activate again the motor overload H2. And that's our trouble, and now we need to check for current monitoring relay and temperature monitoring relay. And now guys, the trouble I found is from the K7 temperature control relay. And here guys, I removed the contact, number 12 contact here. And after I remove, the motor overload on the bridge is gone. And I try to reset the temperature control relay, but still have a signal F or maybe failed this temperature control relay. And what I found guys is this. This thermistor, I test, there was no resistance. Therefore, the K7 is energized or failed. And this contact, guys, is closed. That's why we have a overload temperature alarm. And what I did is remove the contact number 12. After I removed, the alarm was gone on the bridge. And now guys, I put back the wire that I removed, and you can see the F red signal light was off. And K7 is a normal operation. And What I did, guys, is here. This is the terminal for the thermistor. I removed the damaged thermistor and put the jumper. And I only use one thermistor for two temperature control relay. This is the damaged thermistor. What I did here, this is written by the superintendent on board. Okay. The K8 thermistor, guys, is okay. And I use only one thermistor. What I did is here. First line going here, down here to the thermistor, and the other line of the thermistor going to the terminal, going to the K7, and K7 going here, and that's the jumper I put going here to the K8. That's why both of them is working by one thermistor. And I did, guys, just for testing of bow thruster only. Now, guys, the shipyard technician came on board and he opened the terminal box of the bow thruster motor, and that's the terminal for the thermistor. He was said that there's no problem on the thermistor and it's okay. The trouble that he found is the wire was disconnected inside the motor winding, and he gave me this thermistor for a spare. We have 80 degree and 100 degree. If I try to install, it's here.
Yeah, it's here, and motor coil.
Yeah, here we need coil to open inside. This.
And yeah, then open, okay. Check.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Show you the this and summer switch.
So you need to put back the brake. Today, you put back the brake or no?
Brake pad is, and before is wear.
Yeah, you replace new.
Wear. Yeah, new repair, okay. Brake pad.
Okay.
And I think this brake pad is special.
And here, guys, they already removed the jumper that I put, and they put back in normal. Here is the bearing, guys, that they replace on the boat thruster motor. C3 made from France, SKF. It's not the same size, and the other one is number 6417-C3. Now, guys, everything is okay and working in normal condition. That's it. Finish for this trouble, and I hope, guys, you learned something in this video, and don't forget to click like and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Electon TV. Thank you for watching, guys, and see you in my next vlog.